Kinahulog eh.
Nakantaan ka niya.
Ay, hindi mo nakita.
Ano sa'yo niya? Ano kaya sa'yo niya?
Pepe mo!
Maybe this whole damn puzzle thing.
Ano ba na kung di kami kalig? Eh di yun ba mong putang ina? Ano yan, Angie? Baliw yan eh. Hoy, baliw! Ano? Narinig mo yung boses ko, walang boses na.
Malat lang yung boses ko.
Malat nga yun nga. Saan ba nang isimula lahat?
Binaman ako yung malang boses mo na yung ibang paos kasi ano, parang ano na talaga yung
Ganyan ni Jihan.
Yeah,
RG well. Bye.
Papayin na ba yung pagkakasin na kami?
Bye-bye. Oh! Pinatay!
The more I thought about my dad, the less I thought about him.
Okay.
So, I decided to focus on finding out as much about him as I could. If he had pictures with my mom on his phone, she probably had some old ones of him, too. Weird. My mom looked way younger than she was when I was born. What were these? Restraining orders? Against my dad? Why would my grandma have filed them on my mom's behalf? I'd spent 18 years being jealous of every girl who had a dad. And now I had my very first text of mine. Whatever this was about, maybe there was an explanation.
Arriving at the Vale House. Looks like she's home. That was a surprise for you. Maybe a little late, but I want to teach my daughter how to ride a bike. Hop on.
Screw the restraining orders. Whatever they were about, that was then, and this was now. And right now, I have my dad. I finally felt full.
I had spent hours trying to find something to help Dixie. There had to be something I missed. This is your brand new glasses prescription. It was found in the glove box of the Wienmobile. Want to tell me why you haven't filled it yet?
I don't have a restricted license.
Which is why I called your optometrist.
You can do that?
She said it's strong enough that you should have been wearing them at the time of the accident, and that she'd be happy to testify to that. Dad, seriously?
I was wearing my old glasses. The doctor never told me that I had to.
So you had no responsibility for what happened to Dixie? You're 100% sure you wouldn't have seen her if you had been wearing your new prescription.
Huh?
that information right to the judge, taking them for everything they were worth. But he had a family, and I had a soft spot for Donald Choi. I didn't want that karma.
And Dixie, you are now the proud owner of the Wiener Taco.
I'm so sorry, Dixie.
I should sue you for going directly to my client.
Go ahead and try it.
But tell me why. The loose change in my dryer is worth more than you.
Does this mean you're my boss now?
Sure does.
That's when it hit me. I won, but now what?
Hi. I saw how freaked out you looked when you were signing those papers. No one knows better than me what you're going through. A chair, a new life. You're terrified.
It's just paralyzing. Who's gonna help me get in and out of bed? What if there are stairs?
Well, what if there's a zombie apocalypse? What if both Hemsworth brothers want to fuck me and I can only pick one? What if? You'll live and you'll learn.
From who? I don't have anyone. I'm all alone.
You're not alone. There are lots of us. I promise, we'll hook you up.
Maybe this was karma, but that didn't mean it had to be a bad thing. Especially since I wasn't alone.
Brother and E.T. phone home.
I'm so proud of you, Patty.
Honestly, I'm kind of proud of myself. For the first time in a long time.
Why's that?
You know how you were saying you made some bad choices?
Uh-huh.
I made some too. A lot, actually.
What's running on DNA? Yeah, I have a confession to make.
You do?
Bike? I stole it.
Wait, what?
You said you didn't know how to ride. I thought, well, that's one thing I can do.
But you didn't have to.
No, I did. Because, after today, I don't know when I'll see you again.
What? What do you mean? We finally found each other.
It's those damn bad choices. But I still owe some bad people money from a long time ago. That's the reason I needed my car back from your mom, so I could sell it. But now they run out of patience.
Well, I'm not losing you over money. I could give you some. I have some scholarship money.
You went out of regionals. I can't take that from you.
How did you know about regionals?
What?
Regionals, how did you know that that's where I won the money?
Well, I was on your mom's Facebook page, and...
And what? Is that what this was? Why you pretended to care? It's for money?
Oh, I do care.
Are you even my dad?
Of course I am. I even bought the paternity test. I have a look at my things.
What are these?
Look at you. Just waiting to spring now.
Why would my grandma not want you around my mom?
Because we were having sex.
You and my grandma?
Well, yeah, first. Then Angie came sniffing around. She was very mature for her age.
You molested your girlfriend's daughter?
Well, she came on to me.
Oh my God, you are sick.
Oh, really? Because when Angie grew up, she came back begging for more, and that is how you were conceived.
It was worse than I could have ever imagined. He wasn't my solution. He was the problem. You're my causes and conditions.
What the fuck are you talking about? It's
Step one. We admitted we were powerless.
You destroyed my mother. You are the reason that she's so fucked up.
Step two. Came to believe.
You are why she drank. And why she slept with all those men.
Three. Made a decision.
You are why she couldn't show up for me.
Step four.
And why she keeps leaving me.
Five. Which means you are the reason I am the way that I am.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
You are why I am so angry.
Nine.
You are why I am so fucking broken.
Ten.
You are the reason I eat.
11.
You are why it is never enough. And you are why I have this unfillable hole.
Finally, step 12.
He was my causes and conditions. Could I really just let him go?
Turns out Dixie wanted me to represent her, and I won her the wiener taco. I mean, this is gonna be a great year, Patty. You are in recovery. I am turning over a new leaf. We're leaving all the drama behind.
It's great. I just called to see what Dixie wanted. I'll call you later. Bye.
Okay.
College and career fair. All my classmates were there with their parents. Not me. My own mom had been MIA for weeks. And my dad, who I finally met, was dead.
Got you back on the cliff. Another dead body. And who was the common denominator? You.
Not look like that.
Truth isn't pretty, Ben. You've got the blood of an ex-convict running through your veins. You are a bad seed.
Please, leave me alone.
Oh. I can't. I'm inside your toxic DNA. That's why people keep dying around you. You are poison, Patty.
Hey, superstar!
Bob! Hard to see you here.
Now, meet me, Brick and Coralie here. It's our first family outing since everything went down, so fingers crossed.
For what?
My first step towards a thaw with Coralie.
Think that could happen?
I fixed things with Dixie. You're in recovery. Anything is possible. Speaking of recovery, how's that going?
Fine. Good. It's great.
Great, because we need to start preparing for state. I've been compiling a list of talents we've tried, and I've already found a new philanthropy, a mentorship through Association of Substitute Sisters.
You really think that's a good idea?
I know it's early on in your recovery, but I'm pretty sure one of the main things they tell you to do is to be of service to others. Get out of your own head.
But trusting an impressionable girl with me? You don't think I'm a bad student?
You're not. Look around. Everyone here is focused on the future. And you can be too, if you just give yourself a clean slate.
I'm not entirely sure that's possible.
Of course it is. Look, the longer Stella Rose isn't around, the more likely it is she's dead. And Magnolia's memory isn't coming around anytime soon. Don't let the past drag you down. You're gonna win state, then Miss American Lady, and then you can go to any college you want.
Hey, Patty. Tell me what's going on between you and Dee. I thought you guys hated each other.
Dee hasn't talked to you?
No. I haven't spoken in days. Kind of starting to think I can't trust either of you.
No, she's my sponsor. In Overeaters Anonymous.
Oh, I'm so proud of you for going. I had no idea you didn't tell me.
Is Officer Greg believing in me? Or you?
Me. Spent the past half hour trying to convince me to become a cop like my dad.
You gonna do it?
Seriously? A lesbian cop? I could ever be that much of a cliche.
Oh, he's been following me. And he still thinks I killed Roxy.
He still thinks Santa Claus is real. I wouldn't worry about him. I'm gonna go call Dee.
Hughes is a historically black university like Spelman or Morehouse. Yeah, well, I'm just not sure I'd fit in at an all-black university.
Why would you say that?
This is my dad.
Nice to meet you.
Well, pleasure's mine. Excuse me, hon.
Would you like a burger?
You gonna be in the office at lunchtime?
Yeah, I can be if you want to talk.
Well, I'd rather you not be. I'm cleaning out my office and quitting the firm.
Now, Pop, you don't have to do that.
I'm running for mayor.
No, Rick's daddy, Bob. A word, please. We need to have a conversation about this. Rick cannot get into a four-year college.
You knew about my grades.
Yeah, but I thought with wrestling.
Yeah, so did I, but I guess outside of Masonville, I'm not that big of a deal.
We'll figure things out. I mean, college isn't for everyone.
No, he's going to college.
You didn't go and you're about to start your own business.
He's right. I mean, not everyone knows exactly what they're going to do at 17.
Are you that desperate to get Brick to like you? You're acting like a friend, not a father.
I'm trying to work through this as a team. We need to be parents together.
Well, you probably should have thought about that before you decided to blow up our family.
Just stop, all right? You both fucked up your life, so quit telling me what to do with mine.
Okay, watch your language, mister.
For the record, I did not blow up our family. We decided to try things with Bob Barnard together.
And then you chose him over me.
That is not what happened.
Bob, you said you were more afraid of losing him than me.
I told you that is not what I meant. You have no idea what I went through that night. And I said some things that I regret.
This is unbelievable because now you're trying to buy it back?
What's this?
Divorce papers.
You just been carrying those around with you?
I was waiting for the right time. And I think that this is the right time. You have to move on, Bob. Both of us.
Hey, how was the college fair for you?
College rep suggested an all-black university, which never would have even occurred to me. I mean, I'm not even all-black. Are you okay?
I just found out my grades are too bad to get into a four-year school, so I feel like a loser.
Oh, Rick. No.
I had this whole plan to party and wrestle and postpone real life for as long as possible, and now there's all this pressure to figure these things out, and I just got into a huge fight with my parents.
Do you want to grab a coffee or something? Talk about it?
No, I shouldn't. Patty would...
Right. Right. I gotta go anyway, because my dad made an appointment with a hypnotist to help me remember what happened when I blacked out, so...
Heck, thank you.
I was gonna get a clean slate. I needed to get as far away from Masonville as possible. I could start a new life, new friends, and leave all the death and destruction behind.
I'm what they say. Wherever you go, there we are. We both know how your future's going to turn out. You're even worse than me. Why don't you just quit while you're behind? College pageants.
There, happy now?
Does this dress make me look homicidal?
Hello?
You told Nani I was a program? What the hell?
I'm sorry. She was mad at both of us, and I didn't want you to ruin your relationship.
The A stands for anonymous. I decide when I tell someone. This is enough of numbers of other people to call. Don't bother.
I'll be fine on my own.
See? You're so damaged, you don't even deserve recovery.
You know what I'm saying? Without a sponsor, and you know my feelings.
Yay.
Oh, Girl Scout cookies? Awesome. Let me grab my...
We're not with the Girl Scouts. We're with the Association of...
Oh, shit, I forgot. Fuck, I cussed. Shit, sorry. Again. Can I... Just... Listen, I can't. Your coach seemed to think that you and Becky would be a good fit. She just needs to spend the day with a strong female role model.
I'm definitely the wrong person for that.
Are you Patty Widow?
Yes.
Well, you're the right person. It says so right here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a man full of other kids to drop off.
It's okay. I get why you don't want to help me. I mean, there's no way you could relate to my problems.
No, it's not that.
I mean, look at you. You're beautiful and skinny and perfect.
Come with me. They call me Fatty Patty.
Lose the weight.
That's not the point.
How did you lose the weight?
I was putty. I had my jaw wired shut and lost 70 pounds.
That's amazing.
It was actually really painful.
Did the guy just like come at you? Or?
I hit him first, but like I said, not a great role model.
Are you kidding? I wish I could
if I looked different, and then my outsides changed, and didn't make me any happier. You know what I would wish for? Instead of getting punched in the face, a clean slate.
What do you mean?
I would let go of all of the things I hate about myself. I go back in time and learn to love myself just the way I am.
That sounds boring.
Okay, well, maybe if I had, my life wouldn't be such a disaster for you.
What's wrong with your life?
Just trust me. If I had known that, what I know now, I wouldn't have waited to try and be happy. But you don't have to make the same mistake for things to be different.
Is this the part where you pull out a bunch of self-esteem belting activity lists from Vulture and Refinery 29?
Oh my god, it's a great idea.
House, let go of the ring, sign the papers, and move on. They each felt like they weighed 1,000 pounds. I kept thinking of all the things I would have done differently. I never meant to be the bad guy.
Dad? I'm sorry for snapping earlier. I think I'm just mad that I messed up with school.
Oh, it's okay. I understand.
I just wish I could get like a time machine and have a do-over.
Yeah, I know how you feel. It's hard. I had literally just told Patty to give herself a clean slate.
You know what? No more dwelling in the past, either one of us. Let's, you and I, figure out what we're going to do next together.
Dad, are you living out of your office?
Oh, no, no. That's just, temporary till I find something more permanent. Let's talk about people.
No way. I mean, you basically just told me you're homeless, so come on, we're getting you to a hotel.
Oh, Dixie. Don't you look stylish? I love the way your outfit matches your brand.
You have exceeded the 45-minute per customer time limit. Everyone's waiting for a table. I've never seen it so empty.
Want to know why? She's a total Mussolini.
Get back to work.
Dixie, I know you're hurting, but you need your mama now more than ever. You've always been dumb, but now you're crippled, too.
Please leave before I get one of my waiting workers to kick you out.
I told you not to call me that. Okay, you know what? Forget it. I quit.
What do you mean you quit?
I was gonna wait to tell you this until you got your bearings here, but I'm moving.
Where?
Dad got a job in California. Decided it was too depressing to work for you. You know? I think he was right. Good luck, Dixie.
Gina, I've been trying to call you for the last hour. I'm a train sale carrier.
Do you want to explain to me why 250,000 tampoozles were shipped to my house this morning?
Well, I would have had them shipped to my place, but I'm between residences, too.
So I didn't think you'd mind. I got a fantastic deal by ordering in bulk from China.
Okay.
Between the tariffs and the shipping, it's actually more expensive than the product itself.
Tariffs? I thought that was fake news.
You spent all of our capital. This means we don't have any money for marketing and distribution.
I think this is that learning curve that everyone talks about.
What are we supposed to do with a shit ton worth of product and no way to sell it?
We need to make a splash. Find a way to get the word out. We can throw a launch party. Here? Dixie, you'd do that for me? No, I would do it for me. I need the customers and you need the event space, so...
You see? Isn't this so much better? And you can really feel like you have a fresh start.
I don't know. I was with your mom for 20 years. How do you just pick up the pieces and move on?
Isn't that what you were ready to do with Bob?
No. It wasn't. I wanted to be with them both. That's why things got complicated. And now... Oh, look at me. Now I'm single, I'm 39.
You're 45.
What am I supposed to do? Just jump back in the dating pool?
You could. What exactly are you? Gay, bi, pansexual, polyamorous?
The only labels I understand are designer. But all I know is I was happiest when I was with your mom and Bob.
Yeah, but they don't want to be with you, so you need to find somebody who does want to be with you.
You mean I should find another couple?
That's not what I'm trying to say.
I mean, how would I go about that? Is there an app?
Dad?
Should I Google it?
Do not. You will see things you cannot unsee. Oh, is that Pastor Mike and Gail?
Well, I guess a rectory is a rectory.
So, you want me to download some of these?
Or? No. I don't know. I'm not sure that online dating is for me. I like to meet people in person.
Yeah, you're a real old-fashioned. Polyamorous guy.
Well, maybe there's a bar for singles to meet couples or something. Oh, look, Swinger Saturdays at Sloppy Sundays. Menage a mingle in your comfort zone and at your own pace. I can get on board with that.
Not dressed like that, you can't.
What is wrong with my pocket square? That is a splash of color.
It is a splash of please don't have sex with me.
That is French.
And now it's garbage. You're going back into the day. You have to update your luck. No. Lame. No. This.
We've been at this for hours. There's gotta be something on one of these lists that you've always wanted to try. Zumba?
Lame.
Hiking?
Yawn.
Meditation? Oh, but how about roller derby?
Like from that movie, Whip It?
Shut up.
You love Drew Barrymore movies too?
No. I like Ellen Page movies.
Well, at least we've got something to go in. Okay, there is a beginner's blackjack roller derby class tomorrow morning. It's called Fresh Meat.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Okay. Get excited. What's my name? I'm the real deal. That's my name.
Closing in on you. What kind of big sister do you keep in jail?
Hey, you okay?
Mm-hmm. I am just loving the strong female energy in here.
A beginner's class. Maybe we should just box this down and come back tomorrow. Come on, you. Come on, no more waiting. My party more than makes up for it. Have you spoken to your father?
Yeah, I saw him yesterday. Did you know he was living out of his office?
Ooh, behold, the Tampini, the signature cocktail for our party.
That's a Bloody Mary.
That is disgusting, okay? No, this needs to be a high-class affair. I was thinking white linen.
That seems a little dangerous for a period party.
This is not a period party. We cannot brand it like that or no one will show up. We have to figure out a way to draw people in.
You could have a contest.
Yes. Ooh, best most embarrassing period story?
Yeah, but that's just it. Why does it have to be embarrassing?
Right? I mean, why can't we just be proud of our bodies and all the amazing things that they can do? We should have a contest for the best period story. You know what I mean? Reclaim our narratives and take the stigma out of menstruation.
Take the men out of menstruation. Turn our periods into exclamation marks.
We have to make this a feminist event, okay? Like a celebration of everything that unites us together as women.
Well, the two of you hated each other until Tampazel.
Tampazel?
No, wait a minute. He's got a point. Okay, like you and I, we come from totally different backgrounds. We have different opinions. We don't always get along.
All blood runs through it. That's it. That's it. That's their slogan.
Oh, I know, right? Oh, I have teals.
We should print them on napkins for the party.
Like sanitary napkins?
No. We should put it on a poster.
We should put us on a poster.
Wait, hold on. It's Bob. Hey, Bob. What you doing?
I'm officially running for mayor. Turned in my paperwork, got my campaign headquarters set up. I got this.
Oh, that's great. Congratulations. Why are there two of you?
Oh, I had a life-size cutout made.
For the campaign. Ordered me to go around. You should come over and celebrate. I got champagne.
It'll just be you and me and, well, me.
Ooh, another three-way. That's really sweet, Bob, but I can't. We are planning our launch party for Tampazel.
Tampazel, get it in your head.
You're having a party. Why didn't you tell me? I can help.
Well, don't you need to concentrate on your campaign?
Hey, maybe. We can kill two birds with one stone.
So quickly, I didn't have to do any of the work.
I know.
It's awesome.
on the inside. Look, there are things about me, things that I never dealt with, that I can get some freedom from, that I wish that I could change, but I can't. There's the whole freedom. Forget about the outsides. What is something that you wish you could change?
I guess I wish I will breathe. I want to be an actor, but I mean, I hate being in front of people, and I'm too self-conscious.
Okay, all right. We can set it for you. Rock class.
What is that?
My boyfriend. What?
Hey. Who's your friend?
Oh, Becky's my little sister.
You should bring her to the Tankwoozle watch party. There's a contest. Whoever tells the best period story wins a month of free tacos.
What's a Tankwoozle?
It's a tampon with a tassel on it.
Hey! We gotta keep this train moving!
I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Mm-hmm.
Bye.
That's your boyfriend? See, your life is perfect.
I think you should come to this party with me. It'll be the perfect opportunity for you, open mic, storytelling.
No way. I mean, I'm already dying of embarrassment, and now you want me to tell a period story? That sounds like my biggest nightmare.
All right, that's why you have to do it.
If you can get through this, you'll be fearless. Trust me. It's gonna be great.
First time it's been decided?
I would take that as a yes. This is a speed dating style event. Couples are expected to remain seated while the guest stars rotate from table to table every 5 minutes.
Guest stars?
Singles looking for a couple to connect with. You know what they say. It's always best to be a guest star.
Kissing is very important to me. And I'm very verbal.
Translation? She never shuts up.
You're gonna mend it? Go away from car.
Oh, darn it, son.
Bye.
This is so sad. I thought you were one of my parents' parties. No offense.
It was so much better when I was purple Thursdays and TJ on Fridays.
We only come here ironically.
I'd rather be in bed. It's free.
Where is that mother letter?
You like antique and scrapbooking?
Brunch?
Oh, brunch is my first love.
And while we do like to explore boundaries,
respecting limits.
The truth is pretty normal.
Okay. So, what are you doing here?
Well, what we really want is to find someone we can get to know. Someone who might work out long term.
And for the first time that night, I wanted to end something other than that stupid room. It was more than just animal attraction.
I hate everyone.
pala yung buo. Kalayo pa rin pala ako, inanis ko yung jacket.
Naka-live ka?
Oo,
naka-live ka pa?
Ako.
Buti nakalala mo.
Oops, I didn't see you there. Na guys, may t-shirt naman lang sa loob. Pero nagulat lang ako na dyan pala kayo. Hindi kayo sa kayo nagsasalita eh. Lalo mo sa kayo yung timing. Minsan guys, magsalita kayo.
Ah, good morning.
Thanks, may energy na ako.
5 o'clock na eh.
Oh, 33. Kaya ko na mag-isa yan hanggang mamaya umaga guys. Bye guys. Natutulog na ako guys. Good night.